Over the years, he's done wheelchair tennis, basketball, he's done Spartan. I need you
to hurry up, man. Hand cycling, sailing, yeah. Wheelchair skateboarding,
started track racing,
surfing.
And his medal tally grows, honestly.
Yeah.
He's awesome. And I really, really look forward to him coming in every week.
Come on, push!
He's a delightful young man who has the gift of the gab.
Dad barely goes to the gym. He always eats ice cream, and I always go to the gym.
He hasn't backed out of any challenge yet. I played alone, I played on
my own, I survived. Joshua has quite an unusual condition called caudal regression syndrome. This is a condition that he was born with.
Spontaneously, waters broke at 35 weeks. Emergency seizure, out he comes, and he comes out and he was a ball. When I say a ball, he was literally the shape of a ball.
The soles of his feet were actually facing up towards his own face.
It's resulted in there being less nerve supply to the muscles of his legs, to his bladder and to his bowel. And as a result of that, as you've seen, Joshua is in a wheelchair.
Oh, good boy. We were like, shocked. It's not something you expect to hear every day.
The truth of it is these people are dealt a pretty tough hand at the beginning. And a lot of our role is to reverse some of that. Because what you want for somebody like Josh is a normal life.
At the Children's Hospital Foundation, we fund groundbreaking research to find faster diagnoses, better treatments, and ultimately cures for the most devastating childhood illnesses.
He went in for a few MRIs, CT scans, everything you can think of.
We got a lot. We had, I think, 7-page discharge summary when we left.
I do have a heart.
You do have a heart, you're right.
They put it to us, they said, we're gonna have to do something with his legs because they were literally fused. And the doctors suggested we actually amputate them at birth. And we both consulted each other with this and we said no.
It was gonna be Josh's decision. Himself, he can make it himself when he's old enough to do so.
He is very fortunate to have a family who have been enormously supportive, and it's great credit to them that he's the way that he is. I'm still
breathing. It reflects like how we're feeling is how he's gonna act. So at the beginning, we were both a bit, probably not very confident. And we kind of grew with him. We told him, we said, look, people are gonna stare. Let's make it worth their while.
Is there anything you think you can't do?
We still go to Lady Salento for like serial casting to fix his club foot. Numerous surgeries, like tendon releases for his feet.
When it comes to operations, we're up to number 7 for Josh now. He's still going and still counting.
We also invest very heavily at the foundation into groundbreaking research and clinical treatments for kids throughout Queensland. And we've been very fortunate that we've been able to work with the researchers and the clinicians here in the hospital and throughout the health service to really make some dramatic improvements in the life expectancy for children.
Just give him every opportunity. Don't hold him back. No. Let him be himself.
That's what we want.
Never slow me down. Keep, let me go fast.